Good day everyone and welcome back to BFA501. In this video, we are going to learn on how to create a dashboard out of our sample dataset. In order to create a dashboard, there is a prerequisite requirement or prerequisite skill that we need to have, which is pivot table. So if you have any difficulty on how to create pivot table from a dataset, I would highly recommend you to visit and watch a previous video which mainly talking about how to create a pivot table in more detail. So without further ado, we're gonna start our first dashboard. So before we are continuing in this lab activity, there is an adjustment in terms of data type that we need to do here. So let's go to the revenue field here. So the revenue field is mainly talking about the revenue value, which is supposed to be in the currency format, but in this case it's still in the general numeric format. So we need to do some kind of adjustment here. Let's choose based on the column Y, so column I, just click it and then try to double click, or not, try to right click and then choose the format cell and then go to the currency and then just pick the first one. Okay, so yeah, it's now looks like a better than the previous one. So there's a dollar sign and there is a divider, numerical divider, and which is nice. All right, so we're gonna start our exploration on the dashboard creation. So the very first thing that we're gonna do is try to create a new worksheet here by clicking this plus button, and then in this case I'm gonna rename my worksheet name as a dashboard, for example, dashboard. And you can choose any other name as you wish. And then the next thing that I'm gonna do is I'm going to make it a nice and clear looking sheet by selecting all cells within the worksheet. So I'm just gonna use Ctrl A or Command A to select the whole worksheet. And then I'm going to go to the home menu and I'm going to change the color here. So I want to create a darker worksheet here, so I'm just gonna use this color, for example. Yes, but yeah, you can choose any other color as you wish. All right, so as I mentioned before, the dashboard, in order to create dashboard, it requires a pivot table knowledge because our dashboard is generated based on a pivot table. So let's create our first pivot table here. I will make sure that my active cell is within the dataset, and then I'm going to choose insert pivot table. And okay. And then I'm gonna rename this as PT01 to represent pivot table, the first pivot table. And then we'll choose revenue for the values, and then I'm gonna choose country for the row, retailer country for the row, and then product line for the column. Right, so and then we'll create or I will generate a pivot chart. So go to the analyze, and then there is a pivot chart option here, so we can choose this one. And for this case, I would like to try another chart. Let's try this stack column, and okay, that's all. And the next thing that we need to do is we want to copy this nice beautiful chart into our dashboard worksheet. The things that we can do is we just right click this graph and then choose copy, and then we move to the dashboard and then right click our dashboard and then paste. All right, so And then I want to make it a bit bigger and nicer and clearer. So I want to remove all these three buttons by right clicking the graph, and then I will choose hide all fields button on chart. Right, cool. It's perfect now for me. And then I'm gonna create a new pivot table. So this is the first graph from the first pivot table, and I'm gonna create another graph from another pivot table. So I'm gonna go back to my data sheet again, and then I will choose insert pivot table. And okay, so it will generate that. It will generate a new sheet here, and I will rename it with PT02 to represent the second pivot table. And for the second pivot table, I will choose revenue as a value, same as before, and then retailer country as a row. But for the column, I'm gonna choose retailer type for the column, right? And then I'm gonna try to create another graph before chart, and I'm gonna create another stack column here. Nice. Okay, same as before, I'm gonna right click the graph, I'm gonna copy the graph, I'm gonna go to my dashboard, and I'm gonna paste my graph to this dashboard, right? And then I'm gonna hide all these field buttons. Okay, cool. And I'm gonna create one more graph for the purpose of this lab example. I'm gonna create another pivot table here. Pivot table, and then okay, gonna rename this third pivot table as PT03 here, and gonna still using revenue as a value, for example. But yes, you feel free to explore with another field. You can use either revenue, or maybe you can also use quantity as a value. It's up to you. And then the next thing that I'm gonna use is order method type for the row. Order method type for the row. Okay. And then retailer country for the column. Yes, this is slightly different. And I'm gonna pick another kind of graph. Let's say I'm gonna use pie chart this time. Ooh, beautiful. I'm gonna right click this one, copy, I'm gonna go back to my dashboard, and I'm gonna paste it here. Right click and paste. Beautiful, right? So it's a little bit back. I'm gonna make it a bit more compact here, or maybe I can just hide this one for time being. Nah. Okay. Right. And same as the other previous two graph, I want to hide this button, hide all field buttons on chart. Beautiful. Alright, so it's a nice looking graph, but we lose certain control, because in this case the graph is not that dynamic. It's nice, quite informative, but not that dynamic. So the things that we can do here is, okay, we're gonna use, or I'm gonna introduce you to something which is really cool, which is slicer. So slicer is under the insert menu and slicer, right? Okay, and then in this case, hang on. Alright, before to use slicer properly, let's try to click one of the graph. let's say this graph, and then we choose insert and then slicer. So make sure we choose one of the graph first, and then there will be several or a list of columns that we can use as a slicer. So for example, I want to slice this graph bit more detail, or I want to have more control on in term of retailer country, for example, order method and retailer type and year, for example. So I want to add another 4 control, okay, and then I can choose OK here. So yeah, it will present all the control that I choose. So let's arrange this one into a nicer arrangement. So the first one is year. I want to make it maybe a little bit smaller, like this. Nicer, right? This is my year, and then next one, maybe country. Oh, I'm losing the title here. Hang on a second. All right, okay. I still want to have the title of the slicer. All right, it looks okay. And then the country over here. Okay, so this is basically the list of the country that we have. Right, beautiful. Right, and then the next one is retailer type. We'll put it next to it nicely. This is all the retailer type that we have, and the last one is order method type. Alright. Okay. And yeah, how it works. I will show you how it works. It's really cool. So for example, I will click 2013. You see? The graph is just changing. Now the graph is only showing or focusing on 2013 data only. And I choose 2014. The graph only focusing on the one 2014 data only. Okay, this is 2012 only. Okay, and then retailer country, Belgium. Now the graph is only focusing on the Belgium 2012 data only. Impressive, isn't it? And how about if we want to compare two different countries? So it means that we need to select multiple field or multiple data here. So in order to be able to do that, we can click this multi-select option. Just click this one and click another one. So for example, we want to compare between Belgium and China data for 2012 or 2012 and 2013 data. So okay, just like this. That's the combination between 2012 and 2013 data. So pretty much like that, and then this is the retailer type. Okay, this is the retailer type. Right. So if you want to select multiple retailer type, you can just do like this. This. Okay, this is the order method and so on. Right. So, but the problem here is our selection is only connected, or our slicer is only connected to one particular graph only. However, in our dashboard, we have 3 graphs, and the question is how to connect our slicer to the other tables or to the other graphs. All right, the easiest way that we can do is we just choose the slicer, and then we right click the slicer, and then there's supposed to be a report connections menu. So we choose the report connection menu, and we just link it with other pivot table. So basically the slicer will link to the pivot table. Okay, I want to link with PT1, PT2, and PT3. So if I change this one, the changes will affect all 3 graphs, because these 3 graphs came from these 3 pivot tables. I will do the same things with the country retailer, retailer country. Right click, and then I will choose report connection. I will link to PT1, PT2, and PT3. Beautiful. And also the retailer type. I'm gonna link it to others, and also this one. Connection. Yes. So, yep. So, for example, I want to focusing only on these three countries, and I want to see this one, or maybe I want to focusing on Canadian data only, Canadian store only. So I will choose Canada, and then I want to see like in Canada. In 2014, okay, I want to choose all retailer type, okay, for the whole retailer type, I want to see how big is the revenue in term of order method. I want to compare, so which one is the biggest one. So in this case, I can clearly see for Canada, okay, the highest revenue is generated based on web. Okay, based on web. And then we can narrow down here. Is that the web from the eyewear? We want to exclude some of the data, for example, here and here. So yeah, pretty much like that, guys. So this is pretty much the activity that we are gonna do in the lab. So basically this video is only giving or providing an example on how to generate dashboard. So the main lab activity is actually the student will come out with their own dashboard and their own analysis of the data. So basically the student in the end will be able to present what kind of interesting finding based on the analysis that they do in the lab by utilizing pivot table and slicer. So this will demonstrate the ability of the student to extract some valuable information out of the data. Okay, that's pretty much the activity that I can share for the purpose of the lab for this week, and hopefully this video is helpful for you to build your understanding, especially dealing with the pivot table and slicer. Thank you for listening and have a good day.